Morning. I'm nervous but excited. Today I've got my exam. It's an assessment day for pony club coaching accreditation. So there's actually 12 of us that are going through it, so that's really cool because it's much better if the kids can get coached by an accredited coach. It means that they've gone through the process of learning the safety and everything they should be doing. Morning, Casper. It's ready for breakfast. A little bit of difficulty keeping a tail bag on Casper. Any inventions out there? I'd love to hear about things going on. I'm going to meet some young kitties and their beautiful cute ponies. So off to Pony Club Coaching Accreditation. Okay, I've got my kit ready to go. Yes, everybody needs some boot polish and breakfast in a basket. Coffee, water, banana. Yeah. These are great. Yeah, okay. It's meal in a pail. So I've got to get this kit in the car, as well as my little Pony Club working kit, and we'll be off. It's just after 8 a.m. I should be getting to the Pony Club in about 20 minutes. Starting to get a little bit nervous, so I need to just settle down. It's okay, I can do this. I can teach. I can coach little kitties and be assessed. I mean, I know that I can coach. I know that I can help kids with their ponies. And it's great fun. Okay, don't be nervous. Think about each lesson plan. Now, got all my toolkit, so that's good. I've got, just remember the safety aspects, introduce myself, ask the kids a little bit about their ponies. The dressage, that's easy, I can teach that, no problem. I've got lots of ideas. Definitely like the breathing exercise that I do. So, you know, I ask them about what does their dad do when he gets home at the end of the day after work. He sits on the couch, relaxes, hopefully. I don't know, it's for really a bit. Probably a little bit sexist, I don't know.
But yeah, what does Dad do when he gets home after work? He's a couch potato. So you're gonna breathe out. Couch potato. Pretend that you're a couch potato and breathe out and ask your pony to stop. Couch potato. Okay, and what do you do when it's a friend's birthday? Buddy! And so we think about buddy when we ask our ponies to go. How do we ask them to stop? Couch potato. How do we ask them to go? Buddy! So it's about creating that energy and breathing. Okay, so that's my 15-minute lesson, and basically I'll set out four cones for a 20-meter circle, and it's really interesting. One of my learnings has been that you cannot assume any knowledge. You really need to help the kids understand where they need to go on the arena, what a 20-meter circle is. Definitely don't know what a figure of eight is. And I'm talking about littlies, you know, and even kids that are, you know, 14 years old don't necessarily know what a 20-meter circle is. If they're, most of the time, they're trail riding and mucking around with their ponies in the paddocks or out in the bush, which is great, they won't know what a figure of eight or a 20-meter circle is. So I need to help them with that by placing cones out and explaining that they go around each cone, and then when I ask them to stop or go, they're around that 20-meter circle, and I might ask them to stop or go at particular points. And if we've got time, think about the preparation piece. So one of the things that I spoke about at the Pony Club the other week that I was teaching at was preparation, and some ponies need more preparation than others. So get to know your pony and how much preparation does it need. The game. The game's a challenging one because I don't really want to play, well, it's good for the kids to be competitive, but you want them all to win. So working out a game that they can somehow all have a turn at winning is, I think, important to help them with their confidence. So for me, I love teaching the littlies so that they, to build their confidence and to help them have lots of fun with their ponies. So I've got my little bean bags. Might have a look at what equipment is there when I get there. If there's 44 gallon drums, I can do my bean bag shuffle game. I think I'm getting myself into a bit of a fluster over nothing, to be honest. And I know that my mentor would tell me this as well. Yeah, so part of the coaching accreditation is that you get a mentor. Well, they encourage you to get a mentor, and then they can help you with any questions that you may have, and also give you a bit of a confidence boost. There's paddocks, that's a good sign. Oh yeah, I can see a pony club. Woohoo! Oh, very exciting. Helpers today that are making this such a good day. The sun's out.
And we've got these fantastic helpers setting up show jumping as well. It's awesome. People setting up dressage arenas. It's fantastic. I wanted to show you this clip. It's absolutely gorgeous. The love heart on the flank. Oh, pony, isn't that gorgeous? Yes. What's this pony's name?
Sophie.
Sophie, hello Sophie. Wow, and I love your bling as well. I am now a qualified coach. What a fantastic day. That was awesome. The organisers here did an absolutely brilliant job of supplying catering, ponies, riders, assessors that are coaches themselves. My assessor, Shelley, was beautiful, so supportive and encouraging. I'm really excited that I decided to start doing this. I am going to gain so much out of this journey. It's fantastic. I never had any idea how much I would enjoy coaching at Pony Club and the community that I would start to meet. I met some great ponies, some great little riders, some lovely other coaches. It is such a small world as well. So now I'll start driving home and breathe. I do feel a little bit exhausted because of the adrenaline rush from the nerves earlier. Yeah, it's all good stuff. I happen to be driving through Eltham where I heard that there's a Horseland in this area. And I've just found where it is, so I'm going to pop into Horseland. Horseland stock a particular detangler that I haven't been able to find at other saddleries, so I'm really hoping that they have this one at this store. So this store used to be closer to me, this particular person that is the licensee or owner of this Horseland, and for whatever reason they decided to move it out here. Okay, let's see. Horseland have got this detangler. Horseland have a sale on and I'm doing really well to only be getting the mane and tail tangler.
Just one bottle of Shoshin, please.
I don't know if they're coming to the counter on purpose. So that I hang around for a little bit longer. I'm not going to buy anything else. My favourite Ariat tops are here on sale, reduced, but I just actually bought myself a new one. Look at this wonderful store. So many goodies. I'm so determined to stick to budget this month. I've never got a sale on. Lots of stuff on sale. Beautiful. Rugs, gorgeous clothing. I could spend so much money. Oh. Okay, I'm gonna get out of here. Well, I am really proud of myself. Well, actually, I'm kind of kicking myself at the same time that I don't have more money in the bank. But I don't have more money in the bank because of everything that I spent last time I went into a saddlery. But I went in, I bought my detangler, the one that I've been wanting to get for months and months, I hope. I hope it's the one that I've been wanting to get for months and months. It's got new branding. I don't know why companies choose different branding. We start to recognize the color of the package. Time for a celebratory drink. Thank you.
back is thick shake. I'm an accredited coach. We did it. Hopefully this is the right detangler. I can't find the detangler that I used. Hello.
Hi, what can I get for you?
Could I please get a chocolate thick shake?
Yep, what's that?
Just a small.
Yep, anything else?
No, that's all, thank you.
Just 3 5 75, double 3.
Thank you. While I remember, there were some key learnings today as far as improving on my coaching. So one of them is a safety aspect, which is to make sure that I position myself so that I can see all riders in the class at one time. It can be particularly challenging if you're changing rein. Probably the key is to keep outside of a somewhat circle or rectangle or whatever pattern you've got the riders working in. Step outside of that, even if it means, say, if a dressage arena is set up, to step outside of the dressage arena, for example, at E or B, then you can project your voice across the arena from one end to the other and over to the other side, but at the same time be able to see the entire arena at one time. If you've got riders that are going behind you, Murphy's Law is that it'd be at that stage that the rider comes off and you'll wonder what happened. The second aspect that I learnt today, sieve brain. Distances. Other one is distances for trot poles and show jumping, is that you, if you've got a class that is a combination of horses and ponies, is that you set the distance between trot poles and jumps for the horses. Ponies are really good at readjusting their stride, whereas horses not so much. So set your distances so that they're suitable for the horses and the ponies can work it out. So there was one more thing that I was going to say. Key learning. Oh, that's right. Utilize parents. So that you can keep an eye on what's going on with your class. If you start moving equipment around, you can't keep an eye on the class at the same time and also teach. So the club actually wants you to be spending your time teaching, not moving equipment around. So parents are more than happy to help out. They're standing by idly. They'd really like to get involved, some of them more so than others. Which can be sometimes a fortunate thing or unfortunate thing. But anyway, utilize those parents on the sidelines and get them to move equipment around. So it might be, so today it was really cool because one of the boy riders in the dressage, one of the younger riders, recognized that a letter on the arena had been set up incorrectly. There'd actually already been a class there that morning. So that was just awesome. Called him the next up and coming Grand Prix rider, recognizing that. So that was really cool. And the way that he remembered or knew that it was out of order was something that I taught at another pony club recently that I wondered if it was still being taught. And that is, a fat black mother cat had 8 or 11 kittens. A fat black mother cat had 8 kittens. And he knew that the letters were out of order because of that saying. So that's an awesome one. So what was it? Keep an eye on the riders at all times. So position yourself in the arena so you can see the riders at all times. Distances with show jumping. Set that for horses and the ponies can work it out if you've got a class that includes both. And utilize parents. So that can be, that's a safety thing as well, because you can't see all your riders while you're shifting equipment around. All right, done. I'm an accredited coach. Da-da-da-da. And I got some really nice feedback. Okay.